All right, guys, this is the first official test of the new GoPro. This is the Hero 9 Black, and this should be, I believe this is 4K right now. It may be too much, we'll see. And why does that look so? Okay, just the front camera is more focused. I think the camera which is filming might be wider. I don't know how it works. This GoPro has a screen on both the front and back, which is pretty cool. We're just gonna go for a run on an errand, but I did wanna show you this new custom, well, not custom, this new mirror I installed. So I got a regular manual dimming mirror that I love. A lot of these S3s come with the oval. I thought about it, but I don't love the oval look so much. I love this bold look and no edge that isn't dimmed around the edge, which is why I switched it in the first place. Most of you probably never noticed, any of you Audi or VW guys, with your auto dimmer, there's about a quarter inch gap, could be a tiny bit less, but it's about a quarter inch gap. And I always seem to have my head in just the wrong spot where those truck lights, and in Virginia, the trucks are all different heights. So you can't just set it and forget it with the stock one, that's why. The trucks are always different. And then one's leaking through your gap, you gotta move it. That's why I did that. This is so much more solid and reliable for me. You only flip it once and you never have to worry about that. And you never get blinded. So that's why I did that. See how this 4K 30 frames looks. View looking good, I like it. Very clear. Alright, and I got this new GoPro like mini tripod slash holder thing. You know I had the orange one, but and you guys like to see some of the the black geese. You guys like to see the Speedo too, but unfortunately this is a brighter, better picture. You don't need to see the Speedo. We're not racing, we're just going for a cruise. In my screen, looks pretty clear, the sky and everything and the light, but who knows how it looks. Again, no special topic on this video, we're just going for a cruise. I'll punch it up a little bit when we get out of my super slow street. Now is this a, no, the stop sign is not out on this bus. I think I'm legal to pass it because the stop sign isn't out. Okay, I'm legal, okay, they're not looking. I don't want to break any laws for some little kids. All right, take it slow. Oh yeah, I've been on the verge of purchasing freaking all-season tires like for a week, and I just can't do it. Just $700 to $800. I just don't think it's a good spend of the money. With the amount of cold days and how these summers are good, and of course I'm not going to go max out and race in the winter and be real dangerous, but I just don't know about spending $700 on some freaking new tires just for like, you know, a few months. There's so many mods I want right now. On the Holodeck stuff, I really think it changed something, it fixed something. Now I'm not talking about the fluid change, I'm talking about the reset of adaptation. I think that's what did it. It wasn't the frickin', the fluid change was just nice to have. But what really made it start working, I think, was the reset of adaptations using the VAGCOM. You can also use the, you know, the OBD11. What's next on this? I couldn't even tell you. I got, the list is too long to even remember. There's so many things. I just gotta start picking away at it. One of the first things on my list is the rear trunk spoiler. That's one of the first things, because that's gonna completely, again, change the car and just make it look so much cooler. So that's definitely one of the things.